Hi guys, my name is Sandeep and this is my YouTube channel, and in this channel I will be sharing a lot of helpful videos related to everything, starting from my setup, and then I will be covering various ways in which I work, and this includes stuff like search engine optimization for your website, how to rank your articles on the first page of Google, and then how to make apps and earn some money from apps by uploading some good quality apps to the app stores. And then I will be also covering how to market yourself using Instagram. So currently I have 12,000 subscribers on my Instagram page, and all of that is organic traffic. I never purchase any kind of subscribers from these SMM companies, all of which is done using organic tricks that I will be sharing on this video. So a lot of helpful content is coming your way, and keep subscribed to my channel for that. And so let me first start with my setup tour. So I will be showing my computer and my laptop that I have, along with any mobile gear that I use, and how I store my all the peripherals. So that should give you a brief idea about what kind of computer do I use for my day-to-day work. Okay, so just let me see if I can flip the camera here. No, okay, I will be back with the rear camera. Like this video, this currently I am shooting from the front camera, so let me switch to the back camera, then I will show my desktop and my whole setup that I use for my day-to-day work. So this is my setup. As you can see, there is a desktop and there is a MacBook also. Let me zoom out more so that you can see the complete picture. Okay, so that is my setup. So currently I do not have switched on my fan. I have switched on the AC, because if I switch on fan, then there will be a lot of background noise. So if you see here what I have got, this is a wireless keyboard. This is a Logitech keyboard, and it has an inbuilt mouse into it, as you can see. So that is quite handy when my mouse is not working. Actually, this is a replacement mouse. The earlier mouse that I have originally purchased was not working properly. The click of it was not working, so I went to the service center and they replaced it with this current mouse. This is, I think, model number G402. That is a mouse, and that mouse pad is SimCity mouse pad. It is white in color, that's why it has got a lot of stains, but it is high quality material, so I'm happy with that. Okay, so this is a monitor from Eyeball. Eyeball is a peripheral company in India, so yes, that is one thing. Okay, now this, of coming to the cabinet, I can show you from this side. Okay, hopefully you can see. Oh, that is me as a giant. Okay, so this is the cabinet, and it houses I think Asus Z250 is the model number of the motherboard, and it is using, I'm using i7-7700 processor along with 32 gigs of RAM, and I do have a 250 GB SSD and 1 terabyte of hard disk drive, normal hard disk. Okay, so that is it about the cabinet, and this is a USB hub that I had purchased. Now this is high quality, as you can see the wire of it is quite thick in width. So this is a high quality USB hub, and it has 4 USB ports. So I will show you my printer also, the printer, the mouse, because this is a wired mouse, and any pen drive. So that is 3, right? And along with that, this wireless keyboard, right? It needs an adapter, so 4 ports, that's sufficient for me. And along with that, there is this tiny device that you see, This is blinking right now. That is Wi-Fi adapter. So this computer, this motherboard does not have an inbuilt Wi-Fi support. So I purchased a separate Wi-Fi adapter of D-Link from my vendor, and that's what I am using for connecting to computer to internet on my computer. Okay, so that is one thing. And this white one you see, this is power bank. This is my MacBook Air. This is 2014 model, and I am quite happy. It has a very good battery life till now, and it is lightweight. Okay, apart from that, that is the router. That is a D-Link router. Okay, and this is another wireless mouse that I use with my MacBook Air. I do have Magic Mouse, but with using that mouse, the problem is that my hand starts to ache, and it is very difficult to use for extended hours of time. So that's why I use this Logitech. It has better grip than that Magic Mouse. And yeah, that is about it. And below here you will see a printer. That is a inkjet printer, and it is with me for around 6 years now. And let me show you my closet. So here are the peripherals that I use. There is some iPhone boxes, there is a selfie stick, there is another ADSL router, and another iPhone boxes. There are some books here, some documents. Okay, that is about it. Okay, just hold on, let me close it down. Okay, fine. So I will explain to you everything, every hardware that I have in more detail now. Hopefully that will give you more idea about what hardware to purchase for your computer and what to avoid. So this is a mouse. This is the Logitech G402. Like I told before, I had to replace this mouse. The left click was not working, and this replacement was given by the service center of Logitech, and they said that after this replacement, no further replacement will be made, because my mouse was purchased like within 1 year it was not working. So, okay, so they give me the replacement mouse, but they do not give again 1 year of warranty on the replacement mouse. Okay, if now this mouse stops working, then I will have to purchase a new one, and there is no option of getting warranty on this replacement mouse. So if you want to purchase a good mouse, then I will say that G402 is a good mouse to have. It is a wired mouse. So the basic purpose for which I purchased was that I have large hands, and this mouse gives me good grip. So if you have large hands, then definitely go for this. And it has programmable buttons, so which means that you can configure, like instead of pressing Ctrl C to copy any kind of stuff on your computer, you can press a key or press a button on your mouse, and the text you have selected will be copied to the clipboard. So like this, you can configure the various buttons that it has, and do your work in more efficient manner. So that is about the mouse. Let me now cover the keyboard. Okay, the keyboard, as you can see, I told you before also that this is a mouse tweet, right? These are the buttons, left click and right click, and here here is the trackpad. Okay, the key are smaller. Of course, it is not full length keyboard. Okay, there are no numeric pad in it. Okay, and they have used the function key a lot, like these media control buttons. For that, they have given a function key. Similarly, there are some multimeter keys on top. You can disable this trackpad because sometimes what happens is that accidentally when you are typing on keyboard, your hand can go to the mouse pad. So they have given this first button. By using this, we can disable the mouse pad itself. So if accidentally our hand goes onto it, then that mouse will not work with this mouse pad. So that is a quite handy feature that I liked. Now it has this on off switch. Okay, and it uses some batteries to get power. Just hold on, let me remove it. The see. Okay, so two AA batteries is to be used. Just hold on. Yes. Sorry for the for keep you waiting. Okay, that is about it. Okay, let me fix this AC. It is giving trouble. Okay, so now the AC is cooling good. Okay, so let me come to the next one. Next is the monitor. This is the Apple monitor. It is a 15 inch, I think 17 inch monitor, and it is very good monitor, I can say that, because I purchased it for around rupees 4000 and it has been with me for around 5 years now. So you can think that how good it is. Basically all it is doing is it is connected to my this desktop computer, and it has an inbuilt audio player also, not audio player but a speaker also. So it can there is a cable which goes to the back of the CPU, and whenever I want to play any song, then I can use a speaker built into the monitor and my song will be played, or any kind of tutorial that I want to see that I can listen to and watch also on the monitor itself. So as you can see, there are no extra speakers here, right? That is because this monitor has inbuilt speaker. That helps me a lot. So if you are also tight on space on your desktop, on your table, then you can buy a monitor which has an inbuilt speaker. That way you can save up the space of putting up speakers, and it also of course saves the money also. So this is an LCD and not LED. Yeah, it is an LED. This is an LED panel. Okay, so yes, and it's a good one. I will highly recommend any monitor from iWell. Okay, this is not wall mounted. So basically I went and purchased a bracket for hanging it to the back of the wall. As you can see, it is on the stand also. The stand came with the monitor, but I went to market and purchased a bracket so that I can put it on the wall. That way I can work on the computer from anywhere. But the monitor will not hang to the bracket because there are some screw problems. The screw don't go into the bracket, and that bracket that purchase did not go well with me. The bracket is still lying with me and it is of no use to me now. So that was a waste of money. Okay, so now coming to this Wi-Fi dongle, you can say Wi-Fi adapter. This is for dealing. When I purchased this computer from the vendor only, I had asked if you can give me a Wi-Fi adapter, because I will be using a Wi-Fi router on my home. So I need some way to connect to internet from my computer. Now this motherboard comes with Ethernet ports, but Ethernet port is not a reliable way, because sometimes I want to disconnect my computer from internet whenever I am working. So sometimes I want to work offline. So in those cases, getting up and removing the cable from the back of the monitor was a trouble for me. So I knew that, and so that's why I went with this Wi-Fi adapter. Now the thing with, if I compare Wi-Fi adapter with Ethernet port, now Ethernet port will give better speed, right? Why? Because in Wi-Fi adapter there are signals, right? There are oscillations of waves. Now because of these oscillations, some wear and loss is there in the signal. That's why if say I get 11 Mbps, 11 megabyte per second, or you can say 100 Mbps, 100 megabits on my Ethernet port, I get only around 8 to 9 Mbps megabyte, that is so around 2 megabyte per second is lost when I'm using Wi-Fi and not Ethernet adapter. So if you want to make full use of your bandwidth, then I would say that you would go with Ethernet adapter. But however, if your work requires that you have to disconnect the computer from internet frequently and you do not want to get up and remove the wire from back of the monitor for this Ethernet adapter, so in those cases a Wi-Fi adapter makes full sense and you should purchase it. And let me tell you, it had cost me around rupees 3000 to 4000 rupees. So it was a good purchase and it is working fine. It is not going to wear and tear and any kind of damage. It is a small device and I never noticed that it is plugged into my computer, because anyways one USB port is already lying empty for me. Let me show you once again what else should I cover. While we are on the USB thing, let me now cover this USB hub. As you can see, this is by Tarkus company. Yes, now there are other companies like Belkin and Eyeball also, Intex also, those companies also make USB hub. But the positive point about this USB hub is that it has a thick wire, so it is not going to break. Okay, and before this USB hub, I did have one Chinese USB hub, but the wire was same like this mouse wire, right? As you can see, this wire was in this USB hub. So what happened was that since I was using that USB hub from my laptop, and a lot of time I had to bend it, remove it, then again plug it. Because of that, the wire got broken, and it was useless for me in few months only, because it did not work. It would not recognize my USB components that I would attach to the USB hub. So I went to market and I asked about what is the good quality USB hub, and I came to know that there is something, some USB hubs do come with good quality wires like this one, which is a thick one. And I think braided wire, if you can get for a USB hub, that will also work wonders. But this is also working fine with me. For me, around 4 years have passed and I have no complaints about this USB hub. Everything is working great. So definitely recommend that you get a USB hub like this. It does have 4 USB ports, as you can see here. Let me show it to you. Here, the first one is the USB adapter of keyboard, the second one is the wired mouse, and 2 ports are still left. Sometimes I have to connect pen drive, then I have to connect here. Sometimes I have to connect printer. The printer also is a USB printer that I will show you later on in this video or some next video. So the printer can be connected here. Okay, fine. Now coming to the motherboard, right? As you can see, this is a LED blinking inside the case. That is because the motherboard has an LED onto it. Now this is not an RGB keyboard, only the red light is there, but keeps on blinking like this whenever the computer is turned on. That is about it. Nothing special, just an extra thing from a plain motherboard which does not have any kind of lighting effect. Okay, fine. Now coming to the CPU, I have i7-7700 CPU. One thing I forgot to tell you about the motherboard, that it is a full ATX motherboard, so I can anytime get a graphics card and attach it to my motherboard and it will start to work like just like any good graphics machine. Now I can also attach 2 graphics card that will give me a lot of boost in rendering my videos and all the building of my apps that I will cover later on as we move ahead with more videos on this channel. So yes, this motherboard is quite futuristic in that sense. However, the socket is I think i7-1751 socket compatibility is there. Now if like right now it is housing i7-7700 processor, so if tomorrow I want to switch to some other processor like 9100, if that model comes in the market from Intel, then I am not sure if that will be compatible with this motherboard or not. However, after 7700, Intel has launched a new processor named 8700 that is compatible with this processor, so I can upgrade to that processor if I require. But currently, since my needs are getting fulfilled by this 7700 processor, and sometimes I do feel a lag, and in that case I will have to get some graphics card so that my rendering and everything else related to graphic stuff gets improved. So that is an investment that I have to purchase. I did not purchase graphics card during my initial purchase, because at that time this whole CPU costed me around $1,000, so it was a good amount of investment from my side. So I was already getting a pinch from the budget side of thing, so that's why I decided not to get a graphics card. So later on I can purchase a graphics card whenever I get some good income from my work. Okay, fine. So now let's move to the processor. So the processor that I'm using is i7-7700. I will show you on my Windows also that this is the processor that I'm using. In Windows we can see all the hardware details that that we are having, in full details, a brief overview we can get, like what is the processor, what is the amount of memory, what is the hard disk, okay, all those kind of things we can get inside our system once we are logged into the Windows operating system. Okay, fine. That is about the processor. The processor is good quality, I would say. It is not overclocked. So if there is a little tip that I will tell you, if you want to know whether your processor can be overclocked or not, then usually with Intel what happens is that they would release two versions of the same processor. Like currently for 7700 they would have two versions named to i7-7700 and i7-7700K. Now K stands for overclocked version. Overclocked means that manually you can overclock the CPU so that it gives you boost during your extra graphics work or extra CPU demanding work like rendering of videos. So for that you need to install a software, and then you can configure how much speed you want from this CPU. So during those high demand hours the CPU will give a boost and the computer will start to work fast in those cases. Okay, fine. But there is a caveat in that. I did not get this overclocked version because if you do any kind of setting wrong in that software, the CPU will get damaged. It will get burned, and there is no guarantee if the CPU get burned, because Intel does not give any warranty on any kind of damage that is driven by the user doing some wrong settings on the overclocked versions. That's why I went with the 7700 base version. It is giving me enough speed, like 4.2 gigahertz or 3.6. I will show you in the computer the exact speed, but it is good enough for our day-to-day work. Why do you want to mess with something which can get damaged and void your warranty of the CPU, right? Yeah, so that is about the CPU. Now coming to the RAM that I have installed in this computer is 32 GB of RAM, and it is from Kingston, I think. Yes, Kingston. Now there are other better companies which manufacture some good looking RAMs, but since I'm not using a glass or case here, so that is already hidden in the cabinet, and I went with 32 GB because I at that time when I purchased the CPU, the intention was to run multiple virtual machines. Like if you know about VMware software, in there you can create virtual machines and run multiple versions of the operating system inside your host computer, right? So every virtual machine will require some sort of RAM to run. So if you allocate around 7 to 8 GB of RAM to one virtual machine, and you want to run multiple virtual machines, like three virtual machines, so that is 24 GB of RAM gone to the virtual machines. So another 8 GB will be required for the host computer, which is running these virtual machines. That's why I went with the 32 GB RAM. Now, since after that time, after purchasing this, my requirement for running multiple virtual machines has gone away because of the changes in the work that I do. So that has resulted in not consumption of full amount of RAM. Sometimes I do hit 31.9 GB RAM usage, but that is very rare. Initial days when I purchased this computer, that time I was reaching 32 GB of full consumption. I would get a warning message that my RAM system is getting out of memory. I mean the RAM memory, not the hard disk memory. Okay, fine. And yes, there are some companies like G-Skill is there that I know. They manufacture RGB versions. So if you are running glass, basically this one, right? This cover is made of glass, so you can see inside the computer like what is going on. So in that case, having RGB versions of the keyboard, of the motherboard, and the RAM, and some using some RGB lights inside the cabinet to helps pop up the computer during night or when the lights are switched off. So that is one option, but obviously that will cost more, and my vendor had this Kingston 32 GB available with me. Now this motherboard has 4 ports for installing the RAM, so basically 8 GB sticks can 8 GB sticks can be installed to make a total of 32 GB RAM. So I asked him if you can give me 2 16 GB sticks, but he was not having those, so it resulted in me purchasing 4 8 GB sticks, and now the capacity is full. The motherboard itself supports 64 GB of RAM, but since I do not have that kind of requirement in the near future, at least for next 3 to 5 years, so the using of 64 GB will be an overkill and waste of money. So I'm quite happy with 32 GB, and it is okay if all the ports have been used. This means that if I say tomorrow I want to upgrade 8 GB more to this computer, so I will swap out 8 GB of RAM stick with 16 GB of RAM stick. Now whatever I will swap out, that will be a waste, because there are only 4 ports, right? So I cannot have a 5 sticks in this motherboard. So that is one thing that I need to be aware of. But anyways, 32 GB is sufficient. Even 60 GB, 16 GB is sufficient these days for most of the computing work. So if you're planning to purchase a computer, go with 16 GB. What you should instead focus on is getting DDR4 RAM, not DDR3, and go for a 2700 MHz speed of RAM, right? 2700 MHz. There are also 3000 MHz RAM, but that does not make a lot of difference between 2700 and 3000, but the price difference is a lot. That's why I'm saying that go with 2700 MHz of RAM, 2700 MHz speed of RAM. That is the read write speed. Okay, fine. Now coming to the hard disk. Now I think earlier I said that I have 256 GB of SSD. That is wrong. I have 1 TB of SSD and 1 TB of normal hard disk drive. So yes, 1 TB is Samsung Evo 970, I think, that I had purchased from Amazon, and that is working fine. I have installed the operating system into it and all the frequently accessed files like my apps, source code, and my videos that I need to edit all goes into the SSD. Now the hard disk drive that I use is I think 5700 RPM, not 7200. Yes, 5700 RPM. That is okay, because I'm using that hard drive to store my bulk data, like any kind of data that I do not use frequently, like photos, some movies, or some clips of or some personal documents that are just for archiving purpose and not for day-to-day work, that I'm storing on hard disk drive, or any kind of courses that I purchase. So sometimes I would watch some courses to learn more about my work and get better at my work. So all those kind of videos, you got an idea, right? What kind of files do I store on my hard disk drive? All the software backups that I need in the latest day all go into hard disk drive. Actually, that hard disk drive was let me tell you the story of that hard disk drive. That HDD was housed in a computer, in a laptop. The laptop was getting slow, so I pulled out the hard disk from that laptop and swapped in 128 GB of SSD into that laptop. And then since this 1 terabyte of hard disk drive was lying with me, so I purchased a case, USB case, from not USB case, just a case from Amazon, and then I put that this HDD into that case and then swiped into the computer and used the SATA ports to connect my computer to the hard disk. So that's how I got this 1 terabyte of extra space on. Now that is also going getting filled up quite fast, and I'm already feeling the need of getting one more terabyte of hard disk space. Now using these cloud services like Google Drive or any kind of cloud service like Dropbox, that is okay, but you have to pay monthly fees to them, right? So that does not make sense for using if you are having a team, like sharing of data, and it is a lot of data, then it makes sense to use cloud services like Google Drive, or there is OneDrive by Microsoft, or Dropbox, or Mega. But since I already told you what kind of files I store on my computer, so on my hard disk drive, so it does not make sense to pay them monthly fee when my data is more of just a bulk storage kind of, right? Yeah, so that is about the hard disk drive. Okay, now what else is inside this, because I want to cover everything related to motherboard and the cabinet. It's now coming to the cabinet. Yes, cabinet is the Cooler Master cabinet, as you can see from the front branding. Okay, and it is okay, it is quite it has a lot of space to house components. I do not have a CD writer or DVD writer, Blu-ray player here, and it has a lot of ample space to house various types of components, and it has a good cable management also inside this cabinet. And my vendor only recommended me that I get this cabinet for my computer, so it is working fine and I'm happy with that. That's what matters, right? That is the cabinet. So in the next I will talk to you about the fan, the cooling of this this motherboard, or this whole assembling of the this whole assembly of computer, that I will talk now. Okay guys, so let us talk about the fan now. Now when I bought this computer, since I did not get a graphics card for myself, and that is why I did not opt for any kind of water cooling or extra fans, this PC is running on the stock fan that comes with the CPU. However, if you are going to install a graphics card, then it is highly recommended that you get extra fans, and if possible get a water cooling system. Okay, now apart from this, there are some scenarios when you should get more fans. When you are getting a overclocked version of a CPU, like in my case, if I had got 7700K CPU, then it would have made sense to get extra fans. Now this cabinet has options to install extra fans on the back also, and on the side also, like this thing you see, right? There is space for installing fan, the space for tightening the screws, right? So apart from this cabinet, there are other cabinets which are more friendly to the cooling of the whole system. Like on this side, there is no such space for installing a fan, etc. Only on the back, there is nothing on the top also. So there are cabinets in the market which have extra space for installing fans so that the ventilation is okay. Some excuse me, some cabinets also have space for installing the fan on the front so that the fresh air goes inside and from the back the hot air goes out, so there is a proper airflow. Now water cooling is the best thing which we can do, but it is expensive. That's why some people go for extra fans from companies like Cooler Master. Okay, that is about the fan. Yes, in the future if I get a graphics card, then I will definitely opt for an extra fan, or better, I will opt for a water cooling system. My vendor will do everything. I had asked him when I purchased this PC that whether later on I can install a graphics card, and then he said yes, obviously you can get a graphics card whenever you want. Okay, fine. Now let me tell you about this chair which I use for my day-to-day work. This I purchased from a local furniture shop. As you can see, it is made of some leather stuff, and it has leather on the arms also, which gives me extra comfort. This is around 4 years old chair, that's why it is getting some signs of wear and tear. Okay, now apart from this, this chair is quite comfortable in the sense that it is a rotating chair. It can rotate 360 degree. Okay, the arms are not adjustable. There are chairs in the market which have arms adjustable height wise also, like the arm can go up and down if we want, depending upon how high our table is, and they are also adjustable in this sense also, like in the length. That way if you want to place your arms back, then you can slide this to back, and better comfort will be there. This is also in reclining chair. So at the bottom, if I show you, I'm not sure if you can see here from here, there is this screw. This one, let me take it down. So if I pull it out, then this seat can go backwards, not 180 degree, till I will say till this point. It can go back, not beyond that. Now, there are some chairs from companies like Circle which are 180 degree reclining, but I don't know why do we need these kind of chairs. The main thing which I opted for this chair was that it has good neck support, head support, neck support and back support also. So you should get a chair which is in this form, like concave. That is best thing. Some people also opt for this convex shape, that is also good, but in that case the head support will go towards the back, and there is no need for any kind of extra pillow or anything like that when I'm sitting on this chair. Now when I move to some new place, then I will be replacing this chair with a new one from a company like Circle. This one costed me around 7500 rupees, and the branded chairs like from Circle etc, which have this adjustment of arms also, will cost around 20,000 rupees, so approximately 3 times the cost. So this is working fine for me. I may also opt for this kind of chair in future also. That is not a problem. This table is quite old. Okay, I purchased it for placing my laptop and the monitor also, because earlier what I used to do was I would connect my laptop to this screen and then I would work, and then because laptop screens are smaller in size, so proper monitor would give me better real estate to work on. That is why I had purchased this this table. But now since I purchased this computer, now this table is short for me. As you can see, it is quite cramped up and quite messy currently, and however, since I would be moving to a new place soon, and at that time I would have a flat you can say a tabletop with some support at the bottom, like this drawer is there, some two drawers will be there, and a flat lengthy tabletop will be there.
like they if you search online, there would be some setups which show you a tabletop kitchen top taken from IKEA and all. Now IKEA is not available here, so obviously I will be getting it from a local furniture vendor, but that works great. Though obviously it can bend down when we have weight on it, but if the strength of this tabletop is good enough, it can last for around 3 to 4 years. That's not a problem. After 3 to 4 years, obviously there is going to be wear and tear, spilling of coffee, tea and all kind of food items, and then we can obviously replace that. Okay, now this table has a drawer. This was made later on. This table was modified when we moved into this home, and this drawer helps a lot. Firstly, it was for keeping the CPU, but since CPU we keep on the top for proper air ventilation and all, here the air ventilation would not have been there for the CPU. That's why I made some shelves here and from the carpenter. And he installed this drawer here so that I can place my books and other stuff like CD drive, some papers and some boxes, etc. It is closed there. Okay, now let me show you this mouse pad. Come on. Okay, now as you can see, the quality is okay. It is like this one. It is not a thick one, it is thin, it is quite flexible. I have not washed it for a long time. I think it would be a good idea to wash it, but I'm not sure if I will damage it or not. It is not written that it is washable or anything kind of thing. So this I got from Amazon for like ₹200. This is from Steel Series. I rarely purchase stuff from Steel Series, but this mousepad was getting good reviews and it was affordable also, so that's why I purchased. There are some mousepads in the market which have gel support, like the palm support here, which have a gel in there. I also purchased this one. It must be lying there in the drawer, but that is not comfortable. After say 1 month, the gel does not work and it goes all the way down and the palm starts to hurt. So it's better to have a mouse pad like this, which is durable and doesn't give any kind of problems. For palm support, there are n number of things, but the best thing I have found is that take breaks, take frequent break, guys, from your work when you're working on computer. So around 15 to 20 minutes of working continuously, then you should take your arms up and down, move here and there, and you can get up also after say 1 hour and drink some water and etc., then come back to work. That works great, and it is good thing to avoid any kind of problems in the future on your bones when you're working 10 to 15 hours a day on the computer. Okay, now let us move to this braided cable. Okay, now this power adapter came with a cable, and that was a joke, and it broke off. The wire came out. This that wire was like this one, these plastics, super cheap wires, right? Now this is a bought company's braided cable, which I purchased in a sale from again Amazon, and it is so high quality. I can feel it. Like I cannot even with full force also, I cannot bend it, like twist it frequently. So definitely it is going to last me for around 4 to 5 years easily, and it costed me around ₹200. So definitely get it one. Now you can see that I have placed some rubbers on the cables to tie them here also, and on the mouse cable also. So these are lengthy, and there has to be some kind of cable management. So I could not drill a door. The best way to handle these kind of scenario is to drill a hole in the table and route the wire from there, and put the plugs down behind the table. That way everything is concealed, no visible cables and all, everything is clean, and you want to work more and more when that kind of setup is there. But this is a learning from me now, that in future when I purchase it, like I told you, I will be purchasing a tabletop here. So in that case, I will be drilling a hole and routing my all the wires through that, or better, I will have some kind of wireless thing, or the plugs will be in places where the cables are not visible like this. Currently it is quite hodgepodge kind of thing, and these props, water bottle, and these hour glasses, you can see it is going so well. This one also, see, you can see it is going down, right? Yeah. So when I'm free, I do these kind of things. So this is some chana. In India we call it chana. When I'm free, I can snack on them and take quite healthy. There is no extra calories and all. Recently I put on a lot of weight, and these help me avoid any kind of fried food, and obviously fill my stomach also. Okay, now this is the hard disk, right? You can see this I brought out yesterday from that drawer. I had to copy some bulk data into it. You can see it is quite thick. Now can you guess what is the capacity of this hard disk? Guess. Okay, I will tell you. This is a 5 terabyte of hard disk. 5 terabyte. So currently around 1 terabyte is used, 4 terabytes is still empty. And yesterday only I my hard disk was getting full. Let me show you the current capacity of my two hard disks. You can see red, right? Let me take the camera closer. 66 GB free of 931 GB. How much is that? 30 GB free of 833 GB. 20 GB free of 66 GB. So videos nowadays take a lot of time, guys, and there are a lot of courses that I have enrolled in, and all those have videos, and videos take a lot of time, lot of space. There is nothing, no movie in this computer. All are my work videos, the course videos, which I am planning to watch soon. And after watching, they have to be archived somewhere, right? Otherwise, this computer, these hard disks are not sufficient for those kind of files. That is why I purchased this one. This one costed me around 11,000 rupees from Amazon, and it has 5-year warranty, and it is going good. Around 3 years have passed. It was Diwali sale on Amazon when I purchased this hard disk. And I'm quite happy with it. Before that I had purchased a 1 terabyte hard disk from Amazon only, but again the same problem was there, that at the time I was working on apps, and these Unity source codes are quite large. Like they can run a single source code of a single app will run into 2 GB 3 GB, and so if I have around 50 to 100 source codes, just imagine 500 GB of source codes only, right? And apart from that, there are some photos that we click on our camera, some videos, personal videos are there, which also run into GBs. So that 1 terabyte has like gone in 1 year only. That's why I had to purchase this 5 terabyte. At that time, this was the maximum hard disk that was available. There were network hard drives like 400 terabytes and 200 terabytes, but their cost was around $1,000, $2,000, which was insane and waste of money. It was overkill for me. So this was my choice, and it fulfills my requirement fully with no problem at all. Okay, so for audio, you must be thinking, how do I listen to music and stuff? Now earlier I told you that this monitor comes with a speaker, right? But when I am sitting back on bed, or you can see here, this is the bed. When I'm sitting on the bed, then I listen to some music or listen to some courses from YouTube or watch some videos on YouTube. So in that case, I have this Boat Rockers 255. You can search online Boat Rockers 255. These neck earphones are so good. I will highly recommend it. These looks like this. These are vacuum earbuds. Okay, the wire I will show you. Just hold on. The wire is like this, the flat one. The one I showed you on this one, right? The USB hub. This is a flat. This had lasted me 6 years. Now think about this. This obviously the number of wires in this case is less because it is earphone. Here it is housing support for 4 USB ports. That's why it is having more width. However, it is having two wires only in the case of earphone. That's why the width of this is less. However, it has the same flat wire, and I like these kind of wires. I do not like these kind of wires. Where you see these round ones. These are so bad in quality. Even Apple is giving that kind of wire, the round one with its charger. It's insane. This does not work. They get broken. They get tear down after 1 year of usage. This MacBook came with a charger, and it lasted for around 1 year only. After that the place from where we plug in the charger into this laptop, it got broken, and I had to purchase a separate adapter, and that also currently is getting the same problem, and I am about to replace it because I do not want to purchase a new MacBook now. Right, so yes, that is to do for me. Okay, now I was talking about the earphone. Now these are wireless Bluetooth earphone. They come with a charging cable. There is a socket inside these headphones, and this is the charging cable. I had plugged it into this power bank. So this power bank has three ports. One is input and two are output. One wire is for charging my mobile, and one wire is for charging my earphone. Now as you can see, there are two bunches of wires, right? One bunch is for of the mouse, one bunch, you can see this bunch is for charging of mobile, okay, and this bunch is of mobile wire. As you can see how lengthy this wire is of mouse. This is Logitech G402 mouse. Now if you have these kind of problems, like mouse wire is shorter, then instead of purchasing a wireless mouse, you can also go for a lengthy wire with Logitech G402, 502 and all. Now there is one more mouse named Logitech Master. I'm not remembering the name. MX Master, yes, MX Master 2S. That is also a good one mouse that cost around $100 on Amazon. You can also go look for it, and I have heard good reviews about it. It is a wireless mouse and it is quite ergonomic. It has multiple buttons which you can configure to your needs, and basically with the press of one single button, you can do multiple things on the computer. Mostly these kind of mouse which have configurable keys are used by gamers, because they have to aim, they have to shoot, so they have this button. So instead of pressing a key on the mouse on the keyboard for moving here and there, they would use the mouse to move their character, and with click of one button they can shoot also. Once the target is at aim, they would press the button, and that works in aiming and strategy games. In case of racing games also, since these kind of mouse comes with variable DPI. Now if I tell you about DPI, this is how fast the mouse tracks, like you move it a little bit, how much the cursor moves on the screen, that is called DPI. These mouses comes with variable DPI settings, so you can adjust the DPI setting as per your need, and the mouse will track as slow and as fast as per the settings. These gamers need these kind of mouse because various games have different kind of settings and they have different kind of requirements in various different playing situations. So in that case, the variable DPI setting helps a lot. They can press a button, the DPI setting is changed, and they can move slowly, the character moves slowly, and they can aim properly. And if they are running and all, then they can increase the DPI, and then the character will move and they can see around faster. Not move, the character will move as as per the current stamina and all with the character in the game. Basically the tracking is fast, that's what I want to say. So that is about the mouse. I have shown you the laptop. Also, there is one more laptop that I have, that is by Lenovo G50. G50 is quite a popular model, and if you want to purchase a Windows laptop, go for Lenovo G50. It has multiple USB ports. As you can see in this MacBook, there are only two ports. One I am using for my mouse, and another one is for attaching the iPhone to the MacBook. That's it. There is no other USB port. Either use a USB hub or get rid of USB devices. That's what Apple is saying. Now, in case of the latest models, the USB port has been replaced with USB Type C, and that too they are giving one Type C port. I don't know what they are trying to do, but at least give some ample ports, Apple guys. In case of Lenovo, you get four USB ports. There is Ethernet port also, and there is space for inserting a memory card also. There is Thunderbolt port also, and it is so good. I highly recommend that you get Lenovo G50-80. That is the model. I'm not sure if they have come with a G5090 model, but G5080 I have. That is around 3 years old, and it is working great. It comes with a normal hard disk drive. You should swap that hard disk drive with the new Samsung SSD, which you can purchase online and get a 1 terabyte SSD. You can use that HDD as an external. Get a cover for that hard disk drive. It's called case for hard disk drive. That's what you should search on Amazon. It should cost you around ₹300, and insert that hard disk drive that you pull out from your laptop, and use it. It has that case, will also come with a USB cable, and use that as a external hard disk drive. So instead of internal, you get a external hard disk drive, and you insert a new SSD into your laptop. In case of MacBook, that is not possible. They are already shipping this with SSD, but the quantity of SSD you have to decide when you are purchasing it. After you have purchased, there is no option to upgrade unless you totally mess up with your MacBook. In that case, the warranty is void. So in this case, I had purchased a 128 GB SSD. So can you imagine in this day living with a 128 GB of hard disk space with all the videos and audios and all the stuff that we have ongoing in our life? So I had to purchase this memory card, guys. Now this had a memory card option, so I first looked at, okay, what is this? This was a memory card slot, and then I looked on Amazon what is available. There was a Transcend company's micro SD card of 128 GB capacity available for purchase. I immediately purchased it. I think it came from abroad, from USA only. In India it was not available, and it is a quite bulky and heavy as compared to a normal USB drive. It goes whole of it into it. Only the black portion is visible outside, and then it is visible just as another USB drive inside the MacBook, and then you can copy paste all the files and everything into it. So that's what I would recommend. If you have a low capacity MacBook Air or MacBook Pro, then insert a memory card and you are good to go. So that is a must have. Okay, these days capacity of storing data is getting high. That is why these companies are coming up with cloud storage. You can get a cloud storage on Google for around $100 per year. That is around, I think they are giving 20 terabytes or something like that. 10 terabytes or 20 terabytes, and you can scale it up. So basically Amazon, this Microsoft, then there is Dropbox, then there is Mega, there is box.net. all kind of companies are there which give bulk storage, and you can back up your files there. But in that case, you also need an internet to upload and download those kind of files. Say suppose you are having a 10 terabyte of cloud storage, then you need some internet connection which can give you enough speed to upload 10 terabytes of data in 1 month or 2 months or whatever. And then you can, if you want later on, you want to download some pictures, so that you want to print and then want to print the photos or anything like that, that you can for that purpose only you need to upload and download a lot of things. I have been through that phase, and later on I decided that it is better to get a bulk storage like this 5 terabytes instead of uploading and download those kind of data. And it is waste of money, right? If every year you have to give $100, so for $200 I purchase this one, and within 2 years that cost is getting recovered, and you don't know tomorrow if these companies, cloud storage company, will increase the rates of their plan. So when I had purchased this cloud plan on Google Drive, at that time it had costed me around $50 per year. Now they do not have any option for having a 1 terabyte of storage. You have to get 10 terabyte storage, and that costs around $100. So now if I want to have only 1 terabyte of extra storage, because I just want to keep my work files, I will have to purchase the 10 terabyte plan. There is no other option. So why do that kind of thing when I can get a hard drive and I can carry it anywhere? There is no need of internet, anything like that. Now these days hard disk also come with a Wi-Fi feature, so you can copy paste data without plugging in the hard disk into a computer. You can any device can access the hard drive with the use of a username password. These are called network drives. Likewise, there are network printers. These are network drives. You can copy paste data without having to plug in and plug out the hard drive. The hard drive will be placed somewhere with a stand, and it will get a power from that stand, and there will be inbuilt Wi-Fi adapter into it. And once you hook that hard disk drive to the Wi-Fi network that you have in your home, and any device which is on that same Wi-Fi can access that data inside this network drive. And these drives come with multiple features, like creation of user accounts, so that the whole data is not visible to every user. If a user is logged in, the data which the administrator has configured for him, only those logical drives will be visible to it. So if the hard disk is having a space of around, say, 50 terabytes, and 10 terabytes is allocated to one user, and there are 5 users in total, and each user will not be able to see the data that is stored by other user. That is a great advantage these days. The technology is getting better, guys. You have to keep yourself updated on the technology front. There is no other option. Likewise, there are network printers, right, which also have Wi-Fi feature into it, and multiple computers can order printouts without having to connect the printer physically to the computer. Just the only requirement for these printers is that they have to be on the same Wi-Fi as your computer, and once the computer gives a password, then you can manage the job queue of the printer and give printing commands. And these printers have been manufactured by companies like HP, Canon. So whichever brand you want, whichever brand is your favorite, you can purchase a printer of that company and get it for your own needs. Okay, guys. So let me show you the stats in my Windows, so that you see what it is like to see the hardware on inside Windows. What does it report? As you can see here, device name is there, processor is i7-7700, 3.6 gigahertz, I told you. Installed RAM is 32 GB, 31.9 GB usable. The 0.1 GB is used for installing the operating system. Now device ID is given, product ID, and system type is 64-bit. This is a Windows Pro 64-bit x64 based processor, right? Let me go to the task manager. Here you can see performance 1%, 2%, 9 GB is used utilized. Why? Because I have Firefox using 2 GB, Google Chrome using 1.5 GB. see how much these browsers these days are taking up. This is more than any other app. Now disk, currently there is no data copying and pasting, that's why. Now you can see there are two drives. One, disk 0 is the SSD that I have installed, that is 1 terabyte C and E drive, and D drive is another hard disk drive that is also 1 terabyte. Okay, Ethernet I have not connected. These are VMware virtual machines which have configured separate Ethernet connections, and this is the Wi-Fi. Currently, you know, data is being downloaded or uploaded, that's why it is doing 00. Okay, now there is one more software that I would recommend, that is called Internet Off. This one, by using this, you do not need to switch off your router or any kind of plug. Just press this button, turn off internet, and it will switch off the internet, whether it is Ethernet or Wi-Fi connection. It will turn off and your computer will go offline. Similarly, once you done your work offline, you can again come here, and instead of off, there will be written on. Then you can say turn on the internet, and then it will be back again from the and it will get the same IP from the same connection that it was earlier connected to, and you can start working online only. So that is it, guys. All the setup I have given. I will be uploading more videos on this channel, so do keep watching those videos. To subscribe to our channel and hit the bell notification icon so that you get these raw videos without any editing. Everything is shown you as it is inside my setup, and everything that I do, I'll be uploading more videos. So stay tuned and peace.